the Board of Commissioners. It's 5:15 on June 4th. Joanne, could you call the roll, please?
Commissioner Ernst?
Here.
Commissioner Engel?
Here.
Commissioner Wells? Commissioner Vogelson?
Here.
Commissioner Wright?
Here.
Any changes to the agenda? Hearing none, we'll proceed. Now time for public requests. All those that would like to speak, please step up to the podium. You have a 5-minute limit, and please remember to state your name and address for the record. Thanks.
Can I speak?
Yes, please. Don't worry about that.
I don't know. Maybe you can hear me even without the microphone. I am a new owner of St. Andrew's Grant, which is just front of the swimmer racket.
Sir, could you give us your name?
Alessandro La Rosa.
And your address, please?
21502 St. Andrew's Grand Circle, Boca Raton. So, when I got in, I didn't know that they were going to build the new clubhouse of the swim and racket. I'm very happy that they are doing that, because my kids, they go there, and the day I will have time and I will be retired, I would love to be there. Unfortunately, I work so much. The problem is how they are doing it. I noticed certain things that maybe they can be improved. Unfortunately, certain things, they are already gone. They took out, actually they cut a very old tree that they maybe could have saved, but it's gone, so we cannot do much for that. But there are 2 points I see that can be improved. My view is just facing the parking lot of the swim and racket club. And they are built in with blocks, like a cube, a small cube, that maybe is a trash disposal area. I'm not sure about that, because could be also a transformer area. With all the perimeter that they had to place that thing, they decided to place just front of the houses. So, first thing, if it's possible them to move somewhere else, for example, in between the parking lot and the street I mean the St. Andrews, because there doesn't interfere with the view of anybody, and maybe can be hide by some vegetation. Otherwise, if it's not possible at all to move that thing, if they can do something with vegetation, so could be better. And also, the second point I want to bring to your attention is that they extended a lot the parking lot. It's okay, I maybe think that this is because they are extending the facilities, so they need more parking for the cars. It's fine to me. But instead of placing a real kind of thing that hides that parking lot that is much bigger than what it was, they place very expensive palm trees, which are gorgeous, but they maybe can improve placing, I don't know, it's enough ficus 6 feet high. It will hide everything and will give me a better view, and will improve the value of my place and the value of the places of everybody in St. Andrews that faces the swim and racket club. And thanks a lot for listening me, and I hope that those things can be improved and can be done something for our community.
Well, I don't know about the trees. Mr. Koski, vegetation's already been installed.
Well, we did everything in accordance with the request from the City of Boca Raton Environmental Department. sir, Mike, that he's referring to.
Yes.
All right, we'll make sure that all of that is screened out with landscaping. And I don't know if we want to use ficus, that is, can be problematic, but we'll do whatever we can.
Whatever works.
Whatever works to.
Honestly, you can move, it's only few, it's not really expensive kind of installation.
Everything that is out there was approved by Via Verde Homeowners Association. We went before their committees to get approval, but as we move towards finishing it, I can assure you we'll take whatever steps are necessary so we don't impact your view. And if it's possible to move a dumpster to a different location, we'll investigate that.
Thank you so much.
Okay.
I appreciate your report.
I'll give you my number as well in case.
Okay.
So you can keep in touch with me.
Thank you so much for listening.
You're very welcome.
All right, thanks, Chairman. Moved up in the world.
Yeah.
Tom Thayer here, 4821 North Dixie Highway, Boca Raton, Florida. And I'm just here to invite everybody in the room first Tuesday at the Community Center downtown, 8:30 in the morning. Doors open at 8 o'clock for our Federation of Homeowners Association meeting. And tomorrow we have a doubleheader. Mayor Scott Singer will be the headliner, if you will. And he'll be talking about the city's strategic planning sessions that were held last month. And the second fiddle will be a young lady by the name of Donna DiMaggio Berger. And she's an attorney with Becker and Blackoff. And I think maybe the attorneys in this room would recognize Becker and Blackoff as the preeminent homeowner association attorneys in South Florida. And Ryan Blackoff writes an article every Sunday in the Palm Beach Post. And following in his father's footsteps, by the way, for those of you that go back a ways. And so that should be a very interesting portion of our program tomorrow. Come out and enjoy it. And again, 8:30, open at 8 o'clock. And again, it's at the Downtown Community Center, adjacent to the City Hall complex. And just looking forward, in July, our meeting would normally be the day before the 4th of July, so we won't have a meeting. You could start celebrating the Stars and Stripes a day early. And in August, because of all the kids that are running through the Community Center, we will be in the Community Center Annex, which is basically in the parking lot on the Crawford Boulevard side of the Community Center. So just for your planning in the future here. So that's all I got, Mr. Chairman. Thank you.
Thank you, Tom. Anyone else?
Yeah.
No. Let me get out of your way.
Hi, how you doing? My name is Tony DeVino. I live at Boca Chica High School. I live at Boca Chica Country Club, what used to be to Boca Chica Country Club, then became Ocean Breeze, and now hopefully it will become Boca National. I like the course quite a bit, and I heard some rumors that, or not rumors, I read in the paper, I should say, I live on the East Course, and they were thinking, or you guys were thinking about changing the layout and doing away with the 27-hole format. Now, I also worked at that golf course as a ranger for 2 years. And I could say the best thing to have is the 27 holes as championship golf. Gives you a lot more flexibility. When I worked there, we used to have outings. And you could put the outing stardom on 1-9. Your regular golfers could play the other 18. By the time they cross over, everything is fine. All your golfers are out of the way. They do their thing. It's just a better format. And that's pretty much all I have to say.
Well, thank you. Appreciate your input.
One comment to Tony is that we're in the process of hiring the architect, and so that's going to conclude. But in that process, there's going to be a whole community involvement of what do you want. And so that's really the time to, you know, bring your thoughts and logic to Nick Price and Paul Boateng, because they're going to give us a lot of different options. I mean, there's been a lot of talk of different things, but honestly, nothing's been decided.
So nothing's in stone now?
No, but the important part is for the community's sake is that you talk at that meeting and, you know, why it's, you know, everyone who's interested in it, you know, tell them why. That's is the time to talk about it.
Okay, great. Thank you.
But that's all coming up.
Good.
That was not staged. I did not ask him to come. Among 27 holes. Robert Ducate, 5351 Northwest 3rd Terrace. Real briefly, just wanted to know what the status is on negotiations with the Price Fazio Group. I didn't see it on the agenda, so I'm just anxious, as I'm sure a lot of golfers are, who want to get this expedited so that something can be done before the current municipal course closes. So that's my only question tonight.
We'll address it now rather than under director reports. We've had three meetings with the Fazio Price team and their attorney. We anticipate that the agreed upon agreement will be before this board at our next meeting, which will be 2 weeks from tonight. So, they've been arranging their sub-consultant agreements with their engineers, landscape architects, and so forth. And the follow-up with what Commissioner Ernst has said, the first thing will be a master plan. We'll bring it in and have the public input on the proposal. And interestingly, Thursday, was my last meeting with their team. And they said that if we can get a groundbreaking by October 1, we can play golf this time next year. So that's the game plan. It appears that what happens is that golf course contractors are busy during the summer. They can went to sort of a hiatus and hibernation for the winter, and an October 1 bid date will bring us more bidders and, according to them, better prices. So that's our schedule. So we're hoping that we're going to play golf a year from now.
Okay, thank you.
My name is Harold Champ. I live at 6200 Northwest 2nd Avenue. I'm the president of Keep Golf and Mocha. I just wanted to comment about the effort that you people have put into this, and that it's going to be one of the best things that I think the city of Mocha is going to have. It's a long term and a very rigorous decision that you have to make. You know, when I go along with most of the people here, like I represent almost 1500 people. This is condos, not people, in the general area. And most of the people, after doing a survey, they all agree with the 27 holes and the hotel and the banquet hall, some other means of support, just not the golf. You know, so I know that we're working, and I'm glad to hear that we're going to have some kind of a charrette and talk about this. Because we've been, you know, anxiously waiting here just for some kind of, you know, we've been at 2 years at this, you know, and we're actually, you know, we're just so anxious to hear something back, you know. And I get most of the people that we deal with the same thing. I mean, I can't keep writing the same thing to everyone in Keep Golf and Mocha. We need some updates. That's why I'm glad we have a date that we can converse and talk and get this this project done. Thank you very much.
What would meeting be without hearing about turtles? Michelle Peel, 7391 Northeast 8th Court. Last meeting, I stood up here in support of several projects for Governor Lovell, and all of those are still very important. But this meeting, I want to particularly ask for your support of the continuation of the master plan process, which is one of the ones I spoke of. You have a $200,000 request for the next day of this plan before the district. The city really needs to hear that the district supports moving forward with a master plan for Governor Lovell. I want to remind commissioners that a master plan is not a commitment to spend money. It is a plan. That plan is needed to refine the concepts, refine the size estimates, refine the cost estimates. I personally have looked at the original estimates, and I have found ways to be able to reduce that original estimate by almost half. And still meet the major needs identified in that plan. France is making plans now to be able to contribute significantly to the implementation of the plan, should we have a plan. But we need that next step to be able to confirm the size and estimates and talk to the community before we can even begin to talk to potential funders. If we don't get this moving, another 6 months will pass. I understand there's nearly 750,000 or more in projects that are needed just to keep Gumbo Limbo running, from decking to roofing to air conditioners. Oh, by the way, two of them are down right now. These have been things that have been not put in the capital plans in front of you in anticipation of a master plan being put together. So they have been, we're kicking the can down the road over and over again. Please keep the master plan in this year's budget and figure out how to release the funds. If it means requesting a scope of work and proposal from the city for UDSA, please do that. I hate to see this delayed any longer. Thank you.
Thank you, Michelle.
I did meet with Michelle, and she has some very innovative ideas about how to parcel out this project rather than have us spend the amount of money that some of us have seen some of these proposals. But I think some direction, we've got to hear from the city about what they think that they're going to do now and what that $200,000 is going to buy us. Leanne, do you have anything you want to say to us?
Unfortunately, that decision has been a few steps above my head, but I will ask them to get back to you.
Okay, thank you.
So we have the $200,000 budgeted for this year.
What are we doing?
Correct. So we're just waiting for scope of work. What do you get for $200,000?
That's my understanding.
Okay.
Which is in preparation for the city.
Okay. So Leanne, that's on you then, right? Or someone in the city?
Municipal services.
Right.
That's great. So
especially if you guys ask specifically for it.
They're the ones driving the train, so you got to kind of.
Yeah, it helps if you ask.
July 23rd is at the joint meeting?
You can ask for it. Ask for it at your next meeting, 18.
Yeah. We have the budget dollars. It's not us, so let's.
Anyone else would like to make a comment, good, bad, or indifferent? Okay. This segment of the meeting is closed. Public requests are closed. We now move on to approval of minutes, the previous board meeting. Okay. Mr. Kosky, do we need two separate?
Please.
So we're talking about May 9th?
May 9th, 5. Can I ask a question?
Sure.
Or go ahead. Leanne?
I was going to suggest that perhaps we just close the loop because the city did give us a copy of their minutes today.
Right.
So does everybody get a copy of this?
Yeah.
Okay. We can just use this and post this on our website so it's all consistent. Do we want to have our own?
I'm fine with this. Well, before I say I'm fine with it, are there any major differences between the city's version and our version?
If everyone has not had an opportunity to review the city's minutes, we could defer it to the next meeting and then simply adopt the same minutes that the city.
What I read, they're different. Mildly different, but not significantly different, but you know, to me it's more about consistency to the community.
Yeah.
If it's slightly off, you know, maybe I overlooked it. So,
yeah. No, like I said, if there's a major difference, if something was attributed to a particular council member or commissioner that they didn't say or said completely differently, that would be another story. I'm fine with this. Do we need a motion to adopt this? Or is everybody comfortable? Are all the commissioners comfortable with the city's version?
We just got it today, so if you want to defer it till next.
It's only minutes. We can document the next day.
Okay, I'll withdraw my motion.
I think we took a couple minutes now to go over, you know, read silently to yourselves. We'll come back.
Well, I guess there wasn't anything mentioned about, there was two members of the community that got up and discussed the city paying for a portion of it, if possible, and then I mentioned it, and that's not in here at all.
So there are differences.
It is ours, so if you want to.
It's not in this.
Not in there. There's differences.
Yeah.
Okay, so, so if you want to go with a more detailed version, go with the district's version.
I think that's what we're going to do.
That's right.
Okay. So if you want to reinstate your motion. Second?
Second.
All those in favor, say aye.
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 Anybody opposed? Like sign? Okay. Motion is passed 4-0. Okay, now we'll take up.
We have one more minute.
Right. The meeting of the 21st of May.
Second.
Okay. Any discussion? All those in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Any opposition, like sign? Motion is passed unanimously. Okay. Got to ask about changes to the agenda. Anybody have any changes? I did. Okay. So now we move on to regular business. First order of business is budget amendment. Mr. Koski?
Mr. Chairman, members of the commission, Mr. Timberlake is here. Let me bring us up to date on what we're doing.
Good evening. This is our first budget amendment for the 17-18 year, and most of everybody's the golf. So, first of all, you approved, I guess, last fall, and the district would participate with the city in the golf tournament in February, and we need additional appropriation of $502,800 for that. On the golf service, on the golf course, we borrowed money, the city borrowed money in February. The first payment is due July 1st. That payment is about $574,000, which we need to transfer funds for as well. During the golf course acquisition, the district spent about $2.7 million in additional that we had not anticipated. We thought we'd be borrowing additional funds, but it ended up so we had additional surplus that we could reserves that we could put into the financing deal. And the final budget amendment has to do with the Sugar Sand Park, the additional air conditionings that you recently approved for that. We have new addition. The budget amendment is like $3,669,100. It's going to be funded by, at the end of the year, September 30th, 17, the projection that I did for last, during the budget process, because of, we talked about this before, because of additional revenues that were received and expenditures that weren't completely filled all the way, the district was able to add to the reserves $2,392,000. So we'll use that money plus the capital reserves that are in the capital reserve funds of $1,276,800. And that will come back to the $3,669,100 that will match the new appropriation that will be needed to pay for the expenses as I outlined before.
Okay.
Any additional questions on that? Yes.
One question. On the bond payment schedule that the city gave us,
it's a little bit different.
Yeah, it's a little different.
Yeah, I asked that question this afternoon when I realized it. And I was told by the finance staff at the city that at the end of the day, when they had distributed all the money, $8,200 that's the difference. And I didn't realize that until this afternoon. No, we're not changing this for that. So.
But then my next question is do you have to accrue it all for, that takes you through 7-1.
Right.
Is this payment for in arrears or is it in?
It's in arrears, but it's only the interest. So.
It's only the interest. So do you have to account for the period of interest?
We'll talk to the auditors about how they want to handle September 30th. Sometimes they do, sometimes they don't.
So but if you...
We might have to put another transfer in for the for three more months.
Yeah, exactly.
Next year, yeah. So we'll talk to the auditors about that, see how they want to handle that.
Okay.
Sometimes they do, sometimes they don't. On GS, they never do. On revenues, they do.
Okay.
If there is an additional payment because we're in arrears, about how much do you think that would be?
It'd probably be another $500,000.
So we're looking at another, we'd be looking at another appropriation.
The next payment, I believe, I have it's a million.
$100,000.
Yeah, so it'd be half of that. So that's
just half.
Okay.
What is that?
The next payment's due just January 1st, I believe. Mm-hmm. Yeah, January 1st.
So we may be looking at before this fiscal year is up.
Another
offer
that
the
yes.
Without
leaving the
cash. Mr. Chairman, just if I'm not incorrect here, this is not a quote budget increase. These are monies that we had on hand in reserves, and the budget amendment is simply transferring from the reserve accounts into specific accounts for these expenditures.
I understand that. My question was about the additional appropriation.
Same thing.
Yeah, which will come from capital reserves, which is going to be my next question. Okay. Do we need a separate motion for each, or can we do this?
Just it's amendment number one.
Yeah. Okay. Do we have a motion?
I make a motion for the budget amendment that Mr. Timberlake has presented. You need something on that?
Second.
Any discussion? All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed, like sign. Passes unanimously. Joanne?
Can I ask Murph a question while we're all here?
Yes, you may.
Murph, if you know, we received some information from the property appraiser.
Yes.
What's our valuations look like for the upcoming year?
Well, right now they're up about 5.5%. New construction was up about almost 10%, with $429 million last year of new construction. But this year it's $479 million. Our total value is $27 billion, $27.5 billion. And that's, of course, includes the city, and it includes the unincorporated reserve area.
So for the upcoming budget year, we're going to have sufficient valuations to at least, at a minimum, keep our millage rate at the same rate if we so desire.
Yes. The way the proposal that came out last Friday, the 25th, using the current rate, the district would receive property tax of $1,200,000 basically.
In this year.
And that's a preliminary.
Okay.
So is that the what you have on here, the budget adopted, the $23,155,000 is what we were expecting. Is that going to be, you're saying it's going to be higher when it's all said and done, or is the actual?
That number would be about 24.4.
So it'll be 24.4.
Yeah, right.
Okay, that's what you're kind of expecting based on everything.
The next valuation comes out the end of June, which is the one that we use when we do a millage calculation. That would be best.
Okay. So what does the 20.9 represent? The actual 331. That's what they've collected.
That's what they have collected so far.
Okay.
And I looked today, and we collected another million through the end of April.
Okay. So it kind of trickles in.
Yeah, but most of the trickle comes in December. It's very heavy in December, and because most people take advantage of the different discounts. So it's very heavy in December, and then they do tax sales in the spring. So when they do the tax sales, people don't buy.
Okay.
Any other questions?
Thank you.
Okay.
Next order of business is Brazilian pepper tree removal.
Commissioners, we had a request for Boca Tipa condominium number 10. There's a 200-foot long thicket of the exact Brazilian pepper tree. It's grown over on our side of the property, so we've got some quotes to remove it. We're just looking for approval tonight. Melissa went out and took a look at it. It's ruined. It's climbed over the fence, and it's on our property. So $7,500 was our first quote, and then our current contractor quoted us at $6,950 to remove that all. So we would like to obviously just go for the lowest quote and get that removed. We'd be a good neighbor.
It's on our property?
Yes.
It's from our property?
From our property. They cut it on their side, but it keeps growing over to their side. And it's ruined their fence, too. So we're looking to be a good neighbor and get this removed at $6,950.
Who's the contractor?
Who we have out there in Apple Shop. They're doing the landscaping. They gave us the most.
And are they doing the monthly?
They are, and I'm going to bring that up, too.
We have a motion? Any discussion?
They'll thump around it and all that?
I hope so, yes.
Okay.
So they're going to take it out by then.
Good. All right. Okay. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, like sign? Passes unanimously. Next. Order of business is the additional mowing at Ocean Breeze for the summer.
Our original contract provided for once a month mowing. The rainfall has been very high, and we're getting 8 inches. We're surpassing that with the weeds and the growth over there. So we're looking for approval. If we can have some discretion, staff approval, Melissa go out there and look and give them authority to cut the grass more than once a month if needed, just to keep within code. And that would be an additional $1,250 per mile. That includes all the roadways around the three corners, Clintmore roadway, 70, 80 feet behind all the homes and condos throughout the course as well.
It would just be what they normally
do. Yes.
And we're already paying $4,500?
For once a month mowing. This extra mowing is where it's getting tall. It's not on the course itself. It's around those areas. Like we can talk about this because we've gotten a lot of calls from people. On the roadways and
if you drive up the road, you can see growing on the fence lines.
I've seen it, but I'm questioning the cost. We're already paying $4,500.
This is additional areas.
Not the whole course. Okay.
Okay. We have a motion.
It needs to be done right or else we're going to get code violations.
Code violations, and just to be a good neighbor to the folks out there.
Let me amend the motion to let's amend it so that it's moved to approve the additional funds for the mowing through the summer months.
Okay.
So that would be up through September 30th?
Once we start, I think they're going to probably kill all the grass and everything out there once we start with this project.
Well, October 1st, if we do a groundbreaking,
right.
It should be not.
That's what I'm saying. September 30th. All those discussion. Sorry. We're good. All those in favor, say aye.
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 Opposed, like sign.
What exactly is the amendment here? Saying one additional mowing per month.
This additional.
What would you like? Okay.
Okay.
Motion passes unanimously. Next order of business. Is Sugar Sand Park Fieldhouse Development. Mr. Kosky?
I just wanted to put this on the agenda to remind everyone that that project is still out there. It's in the design stage now, and we're coming to over 50% completion of the plans. Probably had the architect come in to see us at one of our upcoming meetings, and then we'll work with the city as to where the field house will be located, and try to implement some form of a plan to fit in with our upcoming budget in fiscal year 18-19. Now, obviously, we're not going to have $7 million to build the field house. I
there's definitely a demand, and something that we need to take care of in the short to intermediate term. Okay, Mr. Ernst, approval of invoices.
I have just one question for Mr. Kostian. We have a group of invoices, and the open question we talked about we haven't gotten closure on was the Mamon invoices. If you get closure between Mr. Zimmer and Mr. Mamon, that you can pay Mamon directly.
Well, I spoke to Mr. Mamon at noontime today.
Okay.
Told him that I would like to have emailed to me or delivered to me a document from Mr. Zimmer, executed by Mr. Zimmer, indicating that he approved the payment of all work performed by Mumar directly to Mr. Mumar's company. He said he would email it to me before the day. We tried to reach Mr. Zimmer earlier. He wasn't available. I'm just checking my emails now. I do not have it from Mr. Mumar. My suggestion would be to approve it conditional upon receipt of that executed letter from Mr. Zimmer.
That sounds good. So I make a recommendation to approve the invoices presented for $1,500,067.17.
Second. Say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, like sign. Motion passed unanimously. Reports and discussion items. Mr. Koski, would you like to lead off?
Just to remind you, we saw Mr. Timberlake this evening, and we are now entering budget time. So the question for the commissioners is whether or not you would like to consider budget items as at your regular meetings. Would you like us to establish a schedule of special meetings to discuss budget? It's going to be a big year on budget, as all years are. So if you'd like to discuss budget at special meetings, we can develop a tentative schedule for everybody. And we will check with everybody on vacation schedules so that everybody would be available at the appropriate time. Or we can just discuss budget at our regular meetings, in which case we'll probably not get much else done.
Well, I got a bit of news to ask you.
Okay.
Commissioners, input? What's your pleasure?
I'm good at having special meetings.
Special meetings for that, that'll be in September, correct?
Well, we'll need those special public hearings as needed be in September or October.
Are those going to be on the calendar?
Not sure.
between, you have to turn in your bill, let's say, at the end of July.
Right.
So between now and then, we have a meeting on June 18th, and we have a probably two more meetings in July,
right.
And one joint meeting, correct?
But you won't be discussing budget on the joint meeting.
I understand. So, but the only thing that might come up is at some point, we really need to talk about prioritization of all the projects and what's going on. So,
and I envision that as being part of our budget discussions.
Okay. Is it beneficial to have at least one meeting but after the joint meeting, or do you want to talk about before?
Depends on whether you accomplish anything at the joint meeting. I'd like to see us get as good a handle on all of our projects as we can at the earliest time possible.
Okay, so actually that fits well. At least we set up what we think is our budget and our priorities. I think we at least talk about our priorities and where we're going to spend is. That gives us a good discussion going into the joint meeting, if there's anything. And then maybe a follow-up meeting, which we could cancel.
That's correct.
That sound good?
We'll work out a 10-minute schedule.
Okay.
Circulate it to anybody. Then, if you've got vacation plans, just let us know.
Okay, we'll cancel. one quick question. When will we have the city budget, our copies, in hand?
We have some of it right now. And we've already had a meeting with the Rec Services Department on Friday regarding the city's budget. And we'll get that passed out to everybody to take a look at.
And
you'll have it before the end of the week. A good weekend reading.
Yes, I was going to say another enjoyable weekend.
Yeah.
Okay. As district council,
nothing
reports?
No, yeah. We are involved in a couple pieces of litigation, but they are all being handled by our insurance carrier, the liability issues. And the insurance company is covering us on all of that. Otherwise, we have no other outstanding legal issues.
Reports from the commissioners. Let's start with Mr. Ernst.
I have no reports.
So, Ms. Wright?
I just want to follow up on the shades for the playground. Melissa was supposed to get us. I talked to Melissa about it. She actually has, she gave us information. I need to pull up for So on the playground here at Sugar Sand, on the large playground, we can put shade coverage up on the 2 to 5 year old area. That won't affect the flooring structure because we don't want to mess with that because of the situation of that. Mm-hmm. So that's the only area that we can. The three quotes that she got ranged from $19,800 to $80,800. The $80,000, it was $19,836, $20,995, $79,892. There's the problem with these quotes is that there is a tree removal out there, and we don't have, that's not included. These quotes do not include that. So if you want to talk about the quotes, we can, and I can hand this out to everybody now, and you can
upgrade. It's been $19,885.
Yeah. And what happened was she put it out there for them to tell us what their best fit is, what their best option is to cover this area. This is what they came back with without messing with the floor structure.
Mm-hmm.
Last year, one of the biggest complaints that we had over the summer when we opened the playground was the lack of shade on certain areas.
Mm-hmm.
So covering the 2 to 5 year old section would be a good start. We can't do much else because of the flooring, because that's going to be a long stretch. But obviously the 80,000 quote is way higher than the other two, so that would not even be factored in here. But the tree removal, we don't have a price on that as part of these two quotes. So between these two quotes, the 19 and the 20, I don't know how much the tree removal would cost. It could make one lower than the other one.
Because they have to clear out behind the fence?
Well, where one tree is, that's where they would put the pole, the post, to put this triangular shade up over there.
So they have to remove the tree.
Right. And they could do it all without moving any heavy equipment on that floor. This is the only section that they could do that on.
Well, maybe we should, it's summertime, so kind of need a shade, but we don't all, how much is the tree removal going to be?
We could get a price quote.
I'd like to get a price quote, and something I think we need to move on sooner rather than later. So if we can have all the information on that by next meeting.
Or you guys could say, not to go over $25,000 and put the shade on there.
Can they provide us something of,
we could, budget items. There's a lot of issues out there that I think may need to be put on the table for consideration. They all have to do with money. So I'm sure there'll be a great deal of dialogue back and forth. For example, we recently signed an interlocal agreement with the city to pay for one half of all of the beach restoration, including dredging at the inlet. So that's a 50% contribution. However, when it comes to the collection of revenues for beach and park stickers and so forth, we're only receiving, still receiving just our old 33 1/3%. So maybe we should be looking at, since we're a 50% partner in that beach restoration and dredging, maybe looking at expanding to being a 50% partner and sharing the revenue. We did receive a letter this week from Jennifer Vestiga. I don't know if everybody has seen that. We'll be getting $1.3 million back from the state of Florida from the last beach renourishment project. But some of those little small issues about truly making this equal partnership probably be items that we'd want to talk to the new council or old council, whomever it may be, at another time.
Susan Sexton had also suggested the Recreation Services Assessment Survey as being a topic, but she's out of town, so we don't want to discuss it more after you, so give us a follow-up.
Can staff develop a list of possible agenda items?
Absolutely, we'll get that to you.
Okay. And if can we get it by next meeting so we can start?
Get it to you by this weekend. Can we have some more reading?
Oh, thank you.
This will be for Sunday.
Yeah, you're such a nice guy.
Ocean Breeze Finance, able to be on there?
I'm sure we'll be discussing some of that.
And my other concern is the, you know, getting the scope of work for Gumbo Limbo and asking the city for that.
We talked with Mr. Calver about that on Friday, so we're going to be continuing our discussion staff to staff.
Just want to thank you guys for being so well behaved. I'm not often that I get this pleasure or displeasure as it may be. Actually, it's fun. So thank you very much, commissioners and audience, for putting up with me for this last hour and not even. I like it when I do it quickly.
Yeah,
hey, behave yourself. All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? All of them. Motion passed. Meeting adjourned.